Hello, this is Clint again with another episode of Killer Otaku Robots. This time I have three hosts, which is great. So, yeah, let's have you guys introduce yourselves.
I'm Killer 57.
Yeah.
I am PC Tlan.
You have actual names too, you guys.
Yes. Yes, we do.
You can say your actual names.
No. Privacy is a concern.
Okay. Anyways, I'll have links to both of these suckers' YouTubes and whatnot above their heads, except for him because he doesn't have any. So yours.
Yay!
I do, but you do? All of mine are unlisted for
privacy reasons.
Because of copyright reasons. No poll.
Oh, okay. So this time we decided to go to BC to go to the Linus Media Group thing, the meetup that they're having there in Surrey. And, we decided to take some video because it's our first time ever being outside of Alberta.
Yeah.
It was kind of interesting for that.
I thought it was Langley, not Surrey.
It was right between the two cities. So, me and my friends are off on a bit of an adventure to see... basically to go all like fangirling over an awesome internet celebrity, the Linus. I'm gonna have like a picture of Linus there. Yeah. Oh, I don't know. We're gonna annoy the crap out of him tomorrow. Yeah, it'll be fun. Yeah, it's gonna be a bit of an adventure. We've never been to Vancouver before. Hell, Raymond's never even seen the mountains, and, we're gonna go across. So, we're going to be doing this path here, how many thousand miles, well, how many thousand kilometers is this?
1,183.
Really? I didn't know it was that specific. Alright, so yeah, we're gonna be going about 1,183 kilometers. All the way over to Vancouver. We are currently in Edmonton, Alberta. So, yeah, me and my friends are going to go on a bit of an adventure here. Probably see some things, not see some things, run into some trouble. Maybe not. Maybe it'll be like the last one we did. And nothing of interest really happened other than some construction. So, even though I really shouldn't be hoping for this, let's hope something goes wrong.
I don't really think there was anything particularly interesting about our trip over to Jasper. That was pretty uneventful.
No, there's nothing to Jasper that happened.
Yeah, the same Alberta landscape, flat, non-ending hills,
straight roads. Hills? There's no hills in Alberta.
Yeah, there is.
There's hills. They're not very big, but there's hills. You kind of just like...
Yeah,
that's to scale, by the way.
And then you go from entrance to Heaven's Boat, and it's like,
yeah,
that one is
the entire trip from Edmonton to Vancouver is about 12 hours, yes. Give or take.
Yeah, because we'll stop for a meal or something like that. Google says it's 14 hours, but they're assuming that we're obeying the speed limit.
Yes.
What's that?
Yeah, exactly. Okay, so in Jasper, we ate from KFC, right?
KFC and A&W.
Oh yeah, that's right. We went to A&W as well.
The baby burgers.
Yeah, I got two baby burgers for Raymond.
Well, one.
I ate the other.
So we're in Jasper, which is all nice and pretty. One slight detail, though. There's no fucking parking anywhere. What the hell? Driving around in circles. Yeah, that was a parking spot we could have used. But there's a bus there.
Is there a parking spot here?
Yes.
Wow.
Right there. Right where we just passed it.
No, there's no parking spot, though.
This is a parking spot.
Parking! KFC! We're saved!
Yeah, they had some crazy traffic there. That was pretty crazy. We did eventually find parking. It was actually easier to find parking the second time on our way back.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Well, we kind of just gave up and parked in front of some random guy's house.
Yeah.
So, yeah, between Jasper and Kamloops, though, that was a little bit interesting. That was probably the most beautiful part of that trip. Was amazing. Had some, like, there was this lake beside this mountain just outside of Jasper. That part is beautiful.
Yeah, right? The water is just crystal clear.
Yeah, it has this, like, weird green reflection. It was pretty cool.
There was a pond that was so shallow, a dike was walking into the middle of it.
Yeah, I wish my phone wasn't freaking out at the moment. I tried taking a picture of that, but the OnePlus was just kind of like,
Well, you should ask for my phone then.
Well, I didn't notice until I tried looking at the footage later.
Oh. Yeah.
I thought I got it.
Yeah, the OnePlus sucks for autofocus.
The OnePlus is just kind of a shitty phone. I'm not pleased with the OnePlus.
Well, for you, coming later.
Maybe. That'd be kind of pointless. The OnePlus is now being discontinued in favor of the OnePlus 2. Now, a review for the OnePlus! we were traveling between Jasper and Kamloops, and the road there is just two lanes. One lane each side, and they're, like, connected by a dotted road, whatever. Just so people could pass by.
Two-lane blacktop.
Yeah, it was pretty crazy, some of the people that drive past us.
Yeah,
giant truck just drive past us at like 160 or something crazy like that.
Two trucks.
Oh, yeah, that. Yeah.
Yeah.
The dark brown or dark tan, not dark gray, you guys.
It looks dark gray. I was looking at the footage. It's dark gray. That is dark gray. Anyone that says it's dark tan clearly isn't seeing the photo editing that I've done to that picture. Anyways. Yeah. So it was pretty interesting passing, like, on these valley roads, passing cars and stuff. My blood sugar was a little low, so I was freaking out a little. I mean, I swear to God, we almost ran into a logging truck.
Once.
Or twice. No. They swear I played chicken. I did not.
It felt like chicken. We were just like, And the other guy was like,
Swear to God, there's at least three guys who actually nearly pulled over because of us.
Well, there was the other Chevy Malibu. That was probably the closest we got to another car in the opposite direction.
Yes.
Yeah. Anyways.
I know my distances.
Yes. Everything we did was completely legal. There is no footage of this anyways. So that may have been intentional.
I thought there was footage of it. No, we didn't.
No, not of anything of us passing.
That's dead.
Yes.
So you never experienced the fun hotel we had. Next time we do this, we need a GoPro.
Yes.
Yeah, we do, but GoPros, they max out at 2 hours. Unless we find a way to wire in a battery pack. Then we could probably get it done.
They do come with battery patch.
Yeah.
Yeah, the newer ones, yeah.
Then we just strap it to the car and then just have it going the entire time.
Yes.
That would be neat. That's why I was saying a GoPro would be good.
Yeah. Yes, and if we had to, we could have had a phone shot, a phone.
What about the GoPro Hero 4 Black Edition?
I don't have that kind of money. Yeah, once again, we ran into a bunch of construction.
Construction everywhere!
Oh, jeez. Yeah, we were stuck by that one spot. It was kind of neat when we eventually passed it. That was probably the longest part of the trip, is just between Jasper and Kamloops.
Yes.
Yeah, Google will claim that the longest part is from Kamloops to Vancouver, but that went by super quick.
Yeah.
Probably because we were doing 130.
That's not even speedy. Well, it kind of is, but...
Not really, no.
Yeah. So, we were totally doing 120. Yeah, because we were doing 120.
Yes.
Also,
the Kamloops gas station, the first one we went to.
Yeah, half of Kamloops was without power when we got there.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah,
the tree went down.
A tree went down and took out a 10-kilometer power line.
Yeah. Actually, that Husky we wound up going to, that's one of the things I kind of like about the smaller towns or, like, rural towns or something like that. Those convenience stores are huge.
Yeah, and they have a lot of stuff.
I know Huskies are normally a little bit husky, But, you know, that one was particularly big.
Yeah.
It had its own restaurant.
Yeah, it had like a bakery and stuff inside. But and I every time I've been to small towns like that, they always had something like that. Mm-hmm. Even in Anessa, it would be about that size.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's always something that was kind of weird.
It's like corner gas.
Although that Kamloops was pretty set up, man. They even had a Carl's Jr. And there's a fucking McLaren P1 in front. Oh! That should have taken a picture.
You should have stalled it.
Yeah.
And we seen a Tesla in Vancouver.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
Tesla Model S.
Yeah, it was pretty fucking sweet.
It was pretty sweet until you realized they went on the bridge with three lanes.
Oh, God, that Stanley Bridge thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
That was ridiculous.
Why? Vancouver is ridiculous. It's gorgeous, but their roads are retarded.
Yeah. Never travel there.
Yeah.
Or if you do travel though, get a taxi.
Yeah.
But yeah, that the Coca-Cola, I think I'm pronouncing that right. Yes. The one between Kamloops and Vancouver.
Yes.
That road is super crazy. Yeah, freaking up and down and squiggling all over, mm-hmm. but mostly south, I guess.
Well, because you're going down through mountains.
Yeah, and ears were popping all over the place. I was eating food on the way up, so actually on the way up, my ears didn't pop at all.
Oh, on the way up.
From Kamloops, which is, what, 3,000 feet elevation?
Yeah.
To sea level.
Yep.
Well, the problem is, when we were down backed up at the Wendy's, I barely could hear when I was doing my auto. She actually had to dictate things.
And she seemed totally used to it.
Which, to be honest, sounds probably...
Well, considering it's like right after the Coca-Cola where we went.
Yeah.
I was totally shocked by the fact she says, oh, yeah. It was just hand towards all the menu things. And it's like, wow. I did not expect that to be handled so well.
Yeah, no. They're probably used to it there now.
Yeah. On the way back, I was actually kind of surprised because it didn't really bother me at all.
Yeah, me either.
Oh,
it was just mostly the way there.
It was probably just my slight ear infection that I have.
Oh, yeah, an ear infection. Ooh, slightly. That must have been terrible. Yeah. So, when we were going down, I was... my blood sugar was a little low. I have diabetes, kind of disclaimer, whatever. And so I was hallucinating a little. Probably just the high altitude or something.
Which explains why you kept saying, where'd the road go?
I was trying to be funny, but what I was actually doing was shitting my pants. And I was like, okay, I'll just pretend to be sleeping. Then I don't have to look at the road. Okay. Oh God, it's making it worse. Just don't look at the road because it looks like we're going 260. Just look outside the, oh God, that's a deep cliff. But the entire time, I was just like,
at least I tried. He was sleeping.
Yeah. So he would drive on to the curb a little bit, making little vibrating noises just to wake me up.
The median line.
Yeah, the little rumble strip.
The rumble strip.
Rumble strip. And so, you know, I'm just like,
I'm fine. On the way back, you were fine.
Oh, yeah, on the way back, I was perfectly fine. Because we had
made sure to actually eat. Trash.
Yeah. So, basically, you know, just all like, around the inside, I'm just like, oh, God, we're gonna die! Anyways.
Did you clip the mic?
Oh, probably. And so here we are in wonderful Vancouver. We have arrived, we have parked, and now we unpack. So how was your trip so far?
Fuck my knee.
Yeah. Oh,
it did it now.
Yeah, mine too. Wow, that like totally screws up the sensor on this thing.
Seriously?
No, it's fine now, but yeah, that like totally... Wow, don't do that.
It touches all the balance and so...
He's busy talking to his mom.
His mommy.
But that's fine, because I need to do that afterwards. Yay, my phone! Now I can talk to mom!
It is 8:19.
Yeah.
We started our journey at what? 8:30?
8:30 a.m.
So about 13 hours. Because we gained an hour.
Yeah, we're sharing a room. We need to take
Yeah.
It's bunk beds.
Yeah, I think it turned out pretty well. Can't wait till tomorrow.
Who knows what's going to happen here?
I feel excitement in the air. That might just be salt.
Yeah.
It'll be interesting. Never seen the sea before.
So, the Tabby Hotel, hostel.
Oh, the Camby. Yeah, yeah. That was a nice place.
It was a nice place until you actually read the rules. Yeah. It said, don't make the noise after 12 p.m.
Yeah.
Yep. But
what? Yeah.
But.
What?
That's okay. When people sleep.
So the Camby hostel, there are two of them.
Yep.
Yes.
We went to the wrong one first.
Yep. Wound up walking.
Yeah, it's not that far.
5 minute walk. Yeah. 5 minute walk.
Funny enough, the one I was looking at on Google Maps was the right one. So when we showed up at the wrong one first, I was like, wait, this doesn't look right.
Why is that a cat?
Did you hear a cat?
Yes.
Yeah, there's a couple cats that like to wander around here.
So the Camby hostel, it's $85 a night.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, no. It was $85 in total.
No, it's $35 a night. Yeah. 20 full potion.
Yeah, $24 a person. That's not bad.
That's cheap as fuck.
Mm-hmm. And it comes with a free breakfast.
Yes.
Yep.
Oh, well, free breakfast, coffee and a muffin.
A coffee and a muffin. For $5 more, you get hash browns, eggs, sausage,
toast.
Toast.
Which, honestly, for $5, there's a lot of places here in Edmonton that would give you that same meal.
Yeah.
For just $5. But this is, the middle gas town in
Vancouver.
So
yeah,
we are talking a different economy slightly.
Yeah.
Slightly.
Well, no.
Because it's Vancouver.
13% PST as well.
True. That is a good point.
Well, GST, PST, and PST.
HST.
And yes, HST.
For those who are listening to us from outside of Canada, we are talking about sales tax.
Yes.
All the different types of sales tax, because we are Canada.
Alberta only has GST.
Yeah, just the government sales tax, just the basic one.
And it's the cheapest.
It's 5%.
Yeah.
Yes. So we love it here.
Yeah.
It's the only reason why we stay.
With BC, they add a bunch of that stuff together, and it winds up being 15% total? 13%, yeah.
Yeah.
So 13% added to just everything.
Yes.
Government takes that.
Yeah.
And 15% is Ontario.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, yeah. The Camby Hostel, actually, it wasn't that bad. It's kind of a nice little location. The beds are terribly uncomfortable, but what the fuck do you expect for, what was it, $37?
24 a person.
24 a person.
$24 a person. Yeah, so what the fuck do you expect for 24 a person?
It was about an 8-inch thick foam mattress. I thought it was
fine. That's where the art was, is foam.
Yeah.
The floors, on the other hand, were so bad.
Oh, God. You step on the floor and you just, feel the wood just,
microwave bacon.
What the fuck is this? Microwave bacon? Or you're saying it just looked like... It did kind of look like a bunch of microwave bacon.
We should have taken pictures.
We probably should have.
We should have.
But, So, it was the floor was pretty weird. The bathrooms, they did have doors.
Yeah, the bathrooms had doors.
Just no one ever closed them.
Which was kind of awesome.
Yeah.
But then, women's.
Because the showers were right near the windows, yes.
Yes. If you really wanted to, you could
kill
them.
They were basically co-ed bathrooms.
Yes. So, I shut it down. Our roommate looked like Z-Warrior Fighter.
Kinda, yeah.
Yeah. But only when he was sleeping. Since
you were watching him sleep?
Yes! I'm creepy that way. I've only saw him.
I also have no idea who the fuck you're talking about. Not the roommate, but I mean the
Z-Warrior Fighter.
He's a YouTuber.
He's a YouTuber.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I'm not too much into the YouTubers. The only ones I'm pretty much aware of is, me, you, and Linus.
And the tech.
Yeah, the tech.
Tech sense.
I'm not wearing their shirt right now.
Yeah, the same silk you will at Linus's.
Did is he this watch the buckle spring?
It is.
Did he wash
that? It is the same shirt, yes.
Did he wash it since then?
Please say yes.
Please say yes.
Yes.
So that's a no.
I also have changed shirts since then. Also, this recording is the day after, not a week later.
No, I know you took the shot that all day.
Anyways. So yeah, there was the hostel. That was kind of neat. Yeah. I couldn't sleep at all that first night. It's partially because we were excited, and also because that bed was almost impossible to sleep on.
I tried to help them sleep by playing Pi on my phone.
It worked.
It really did.
For a few hours, I actually did sleep.
Because of Pi.
Just getting Cortana to read Pi.
Yes.
To the millionth digit.
Yeah.
Which is crazy. He's just like for 20, like half an hour, just the computer's just reading Pi.
About 5 minutes into it, I was asleep.
Yeah, pretty much.
Which is funny because
the hostel is
great, but there's a bar underneath that plays loud music until 2 a.m.
God, yes. It was the same song looping over for 3 hours.
No, it wasn't. They switched it up.
Oh, yeah, they changed the song after about an hour and a half, didn't they?
No. After, 20 minutes.
Okay. I don't know. It was terrible.
It just sounded way too long.
Thursday morning, we woke up not really, because we were kind of up already, because we couldn't sleep very much. But I wound up going across Vancouver and Richmond. Oh, fucking Richmond. But yeah, Stanley Park. Stanley Park was nice. That was probably, the best pictures I've ever taken, kind of thing.
Yeah, that park's nice, gorgeous. Scenery.
Yeah. We were in a hurry.
Wasn't it Friday morning, not Thursday morning?
Thursday. It was a Thursday.
Was it?
We were there Friday. Yeah. Friday.
We were there Friday. You are correct. Yeah. Friday morning.
Friday
morning.
Got there Thursday Stanley night. Park.
Hello. It's early morning on the 21st. Yeah, this is the meetup day. And we've arrived. We're in wonderful Vancouver. Look at that sight. That's amazing. That's all pretty cool here. So we're tired as fuck, but we got a lot of stuff to do. We're going around seeing the sights. We're also going to visit a couple of fish and chips places because, by the ocean, might as well get some fucking fish. And yeah, looking like a good day so far. Let's see how the rest of this works out. All right.
So yeah, Friday morning, we were at Stanley Park. That place was gorgeous.
Yeah, it took half an hour to get there. Even though it should only take 20.
Yeah, traffic.
No, we were in the one lane.
Still, traffic. Traffic,
well, yes. We didn't know that...
We were in the wrong lane.
Well, it's because in Edmonton, we have bus lanes and biking lanes. But, you get caught driving in those, you get a ticket right away. In Vancouver, they also allow carpooling.
Yes.
Which means if your car has more than 3 people, you're perfectly free to go in there. And the people there, they just go in there all the time. Yes. So we didn't know we could actually pull into that until we start reading the signs, because we're sitting there in gridlock going, well, I'm fucking bored. What's that sign say? It says we can change into that lane. Let's do this now.
That's quite awesome.
And then all of a sudden, hey, we're in Stanley Park.
Basically, yeah. And we actually rented a 2015 Chevy Malibu for this.
I hate that car.
It was a great car. I mean, other than the entertainment system, it was a great ride.
The entertainment system was shit. The back seat's terribly uncomfortable.
And, I can attest to that.
And yeah, as a passenger, that car's shit. As a driver, apparently, it's fine.
Yeah.
Yeah. I did enjoy the front seat on the way down. I hated the back seat on the way back.
Also, that leg. Whenever you, kind of gently push down on the accelerator, you'd be like, 2, 1. For no reason.
Turbo leg.
No, there's no turbo in that.
City engine.
Yeah.
City engine.
Well, it was an eco engine.
It sucks itself off.
Yeah. It has auto stop. When your foot is on the brake, the engine turns off.
Which kind of freaked us out the first time, because we're just at an intersection, and we just hear a...
We're like,
Why?
Why
shall you take your foot off the brake and the engine starts? It's like, what?
Yeah, it'd be nice if they told us about that.
Yeah.
Anyways.
It saved us quite a bit of gas, so we can't complain.
Yeah. So we went to that one crazy mall to try to see
Aberdeen NCIX. Aberdeen Mall.
That
mall is like full of English.
Shameless mall.
Oh god, yeah.
Great stores though.
Yeah, great stores. There's an NCIX.
They also had an arcade there. Nice little nice little arcade with totally perfectly sized for someone like me.
Insert footage here.
Yeah, I mean I totally and perfectly fit in that thing. It was easily without an issue.
Yeah.
No comment.
Yes. Yeah, they also have like a bunch of Gundam games. That was kind of
Those looked good.
Wound up going to NCIX, which is kind of neat because like I ordered from there a bunch, and NCIX is where Linus started for doing their tech tips.
Mm-hmm.
It's not that great in my opinion.
It's like a smaller, cheaper version of Memory Express.
Yeah, but we were also going to one of their like shit locations, not their main one.
This is true.
True.
We don't know where the fuck we're going. We're not going to be able to find the main one.
But it still reminds me more of Memory Express or any computer shop that it's
BCOM.
BCOM.
Yeah, it is a lot like BCOM, but a lot cleaner.
Mm.
Oh god. Never then.
Yeah, from there, met up with my cousin, and we wound up eating some fish and chips.
Which is not cheap.
Well, it wasn't that bad. If you get good fish and chips here, it's at least $20 a person.
Not at Joyce only.
But that's
Joyce only. That is not good fish, though.
That is about what I had, though.
No.
For me, it was the same.
See, mine was kind of weird. Half of it was, like, not the greatest, but the other half was actually really fun.
To me, mine was all really good.
Which means what you're talking about earlier with the cooler, they're keeping it too close to the ice.
Yeah,
because mine was partially frozen.
Yeah.
What it tasted like.
Yeah.
Mine was all good.
Yeah, like, the first half of mine was like, but the rest was super awesome.
Yeah.
I'm fairly picky, though, when it comes to fish.
Oh, yeah, that's one of the things that's excusable for that. The fries were really good.
Yeah, I really liked the fries.
I hated the fries.
Yeah. So, yeah, the fish and chips place, that was pretty good. Getting there. Oh, God, Richmond has the worst fucking roads I've ever seen.
And we illegally parked.
We didn't know that we illegally parked. They paint the side of the road yellow for the spots you're not allowed to park, but there wasn't any signage or anything to
Yeah, that's something we don't do in Alberta.
Yeah, there's signage everywhere telling you where you can.
Yeah. Apparently Jasper has that too, but they have signs as well.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, Alberta, we don't bother really painting the roads at all. Well, we do sometimes.
Because you will never see it under the snow.
And when the snow was melted, all the things you've put on the road are now gone.
Yes.
Yeah. So when we were driving around Richmond, there was, where was it? It was a number one street. A number two street. And then, like, on the other side of that, there was a first Ave, then a second Ave. And then it, like, went on to, like, 5th Ave Southwest or something like that.
Yeah, it was so bad.
It was so fucked up. And we were going down River Road, and Google was like, turn off River Road onto River Road. And we're just, what? And I look at the map. Going this way is River Road. Going, like, this road here? Also River Road! You're not supposed to do that! Maps 101, people!
Yeah, and then later on they join again and become River Street.
Yes.
Yes, that was what taught it.
So we were just like, god damn. If we didn't have Google Maps, we would have no idea where we were. Every street was like a one-way and where you couldn't turn left. So like, there's Richmond there. We're trying to get from, like, there to there, and it maps us a route of, like...
Yeah, it was so bad. So many one-way streets.
Yeah, we were talking to some of the people who live there, and they're like, oh, it's not that bad. Don't use Richmond as an example.
Vancouver was pretty bad, though, as well.
Well, Vancouver, it was okay.
It was decent.
To be expected for the small amount, like the small area they have that they could actually build roads on.
Yeah,
true. And the sheer amount of people.
Yeah.
I give that a pass. It actually had a pretty decent transportation network, all things considered. Yeah. Richmond had no fucking excuse. Their population density was only a little bit higher than here.
Yeah.
And it was just retarded.
Yes.
Surrey and Langley, they were fine.
Yeah.
Their roads were normal.
Yeah.
So we after fish and chips, we drove from Richmond to Surrey, BC, to the meetup.
Yeah.
We ended we got there around 1:30.
Yeah.
About that, yeah.
After a long trip, we have finally made it to Linus Media Group headquarters. Oh, headquarters is an interesting term. Now, there are quite a few cars here. So, I seen a group of people earlier. So I have a bit of a suspicion that it is, pretty big group of people at this event. Let's just see how ridiculous this is. Drinking a milkshake. Carrying a camera. Yeah, that's a great idea. Yeah, I have a pretty good idea what all these people are parked here for. Holy freaking crap. I wonder if I can see it from here. Let's zoom in. Look at all those fucking people. Yeah, it's gonna be interesting. A little bit of construction.
We turned right around.
We turned right around to get some money.
To get some money and some food, because we showed up there and there's just
people,
huge amounts of people, like what, 200-300 people?
300 people, yeah.
It was crazy. Like when they're first talking about it, they're thinking, oh, it might be like 50 people or something. I knew it was going to be higher than that because, I mean, this is Linus. We're traveling from fucking Edmonton, there's going to be other people like that doing this.
Oh, yeah.
This guy's 1.5 million subscribers.
People from Europe, too.
Yeah. I was talking to a guy from Germany. He brought in some coins and stuff like that. Apparently a couple people did that.
Yeah.
Well, I suppose it makes sense, because, like,
you have the money on you.
Yeah, you just have your own currency in your wallet.
Yeah, and you really don't need to transfer it over.
Yeah.
You don't need to exchange it.
Yeah, especially in other countries, because here in Canada, the majority of what everyone uses is just debit.
Yeah.
But, in the States or a lot of other parts of the country, they don't really use debit that much. Almost everything's done in cash.
Yeah. But a lot of places do have the ability to exchange money at the store.
Yeah.
Not all of them do.
Well, yeah, but the places that will have them will be tourist destinations.
Which is pretty awesome.
Which that's the main thing I like, that we're just going to, like, Vancouver and not some other country or something, because everything is basically the same.
Yeah.
Yeah,
so we managed to get to the meetup.
As soon as we got there, we noticed that Linus was on an up desk.
Yeah, that thing is cool. It was weird seeing him on that thing.
Yeah,
he was doing his first giveaway.
Yeah.
First unboxing.
Yeah, the first unboxing. Yeah. The Intel Master System.
Yeah.
No, he was already done that.
No, he was doing that. He was finishing it up when we showed up.
Yeah.
Well, no, what I'm saying is he was opening up the second box.
No, that was later.
It was like 2 minutes after.
No, it was like...
Clint's thinking about
40 minutes.
Not the trait. I'm talking that box that he didn't fully open. He opened up the Saturn box he got from Intel, which was the motherboard.
Oh, that, right.
WAM and everything.
Yeah.
He didn't open it because peanuts started.
Packing peanuts.
But if you really want to know what's in that box, they're all people that have opened that.
Oh, yeah, on lots of other channels I've seen. Like,
the node has opened it.
Intel has sent that out to, like, fucking everyone.
Man. I'm sure even the node got it, Will. Which was awesome.
Yeah.
No, that was actually
pretty great. Techno Buffalo, where most of what they do is just phones.
Yeah, so pretty much everyone got that Intel chip who was a reviewer.
Yeah. I kind of want to be a reviewer now. Like hardware reviewer. I might wind up doing a couple. I have some things I wouldn't mind reviewing. Maybe probably headphones or something, just because that's what I have laying around.
Yeah.
So it was pretty neat seeing Linus in person, doing a couple of videos, wound up in a couple of them. That was kind of nice.
Me creepily in the background. And so, I don't mean that as a thought. I was creepily in the background.
So Shiro, Mr. Cat, what was it like to be on the WAN show and get to ask Linus a question?
It was great.
What did you ask? I don't remember.
I was the person who asked Linus, what are you going to do with your 3D printer? Are you going to print anything practical?
What can I do for you?
What are you planning to print with your 3D printer that's actually practical?
Okay, the first practical thing you'll see printed is a shroud for our new router that is going to handle our new gigabit internet connection. And it needs a cooling shroud because I built using standard components in a 1U case, and we couldn't find a way to cool the CPU very well without that shroud, which we hope works, but we don't know yet.
Yeah,
and which his answer was the shroud for the server.
So he was talking about the router. They already did one for the server.
Well, the router is the server.
Yes.
But that's the server he was talking about?
Yeah, the 1U.
Yeah.
Oh, so what he talked about was what he already fucking printed.
Yes. Oh, and geez. That's why he needed that motherboard again.
Apparently he killed that motherboard, so he needs to buy one off of
He bought it.
Yeah.
150 plus, I think he said.
Yeah, it was about 180 or something.
Off of eBay.
Yeah. It's an outdated motherboard he needed to buy.
Well, yeah, because he already printed the shroud, and the case is set up, and the software is probably already installed.
Yeah.
No, he was dead into the software.
Oh. What is he using? Did he ever say what?
How did he kill that motherboard?
I think he's using pfSense.
pfSense would make sense. That's what we use. So, yeah, we managed to get on the WAN show. I wound up trolling them a little bit. their videos.
Being the first and only person to get thrown off really fast.
So normally, when we want to get questions or comments from the audience, we take to Twitter. But the audience is here. So I would like for Luke to be my doorman here. And if anyone would like to come and do a live Twitter blitz, and we'll get over here. Don't be shy. Don't put up your hand like some kind of polite person. What do you think this is, Canada?
We have one candidate. Come here, sir.
Yeah, come on in. Show. Come on in. So what do you got?
All right. So, Linus, what was it like to invent Linux?
Well, gee, get out of here for one thing. And thank you for your question. I did not invent Linux. Common misconception, especially, you're wearing a Tech Syndicate shirt. Did he send you?
No.
I wish. So, common misconception, especially on Reddit/r/PC Master Race, where it's like, I have my own tag, and people are like every time, there's like one with upvotes. It's like, I came here expecting the other Linus. I was disappointed. I'm sorry. I can't be him. I just make YouTube videos.
He was
the first person to ask a question, and Linus was just like, go away!
Hey, I came back and asked a different one.
Yes, this is true.
Yeah.
I'm surprised he allowed you.
The second question was a legit one. It was a normal question. Okay. I don't remember what it was.
He did think...
because he was out of it by then.
My blood sugar started getting out of whack again. I think it was mostly heat stroke.
Yeah.
Well, I have the best job on Earth. I don't speak for Ed.
It may not be the best paying,
but he has a pretty cool job. What's up?
All right, I got a serious question this
time.
All right, so about a year ago, you had a guest host on, Dotto.
Steve.
Dotto and Data, yeah. And I was wondering if there's anyone else like that was a huge source of inspiration.
You know what? Actually, that's a great question, because this Sunday, I am going down to chill with one of my main inspirations when I was starting up on YouTube. Chris Perillo, also known as Locker Gnome, is going to be hosting an event called Vlogger Fair this weekend in Seattle. Yeah, no, Chris was a huge inspiration for me because he was pardon my French, he was the shit when it came to tech on YouTube when I was first getting started. No one could touch that guy. And I didn't really follow the phone guys, like your John Rettingers and your Soldier Knows Best, and I didn't really follow that stuff. So when it came to, like, computer tech, it was him. So, I've learned a lot from Chris over the years. We've hung out a few times, whether it's at an airport on our way back from that AMD Hawaii event or whatever else, and, he's a huge inspiration for me.
We were there for 7 hours.
7 hours.
Yeah.
In the heat.
Yeah, that was pretty harsh, pretty intense. Each of us wound up buying a case. I wound up buying a
Raven
RVZ01. It's just over there. I'm too lazy to get it. You wound up getting a
Cooler Master N600.
Terrence case, right?
Terrence, yeah. I got Terrence water cooling case.
Yeah, from Whole Room Water Cooling. He got Terrence case.
Yeah.
How much do you want to pay in for that?
20.
20 bucks. Yeah, I paid 35 for my Raven case.
Since you bought it not at auction.
Yeah, I bought it before they started the auction. Yeah.
It probably would have been done by then.
I paid $15 for a Lee and Lee PCQ07.
Yeah, it's actually not that bad of a case. Yeah, you got a pretty good haul on that.
Yeah, they don't make that one anymore.
And a little tiny battery pack thing that had Wi-Fi. Right?
Wi-Fi bucks. And the ability to have an SD card.
Yeah, it had a media card reader. It was a battery backup. It also
had a USB
port. So it was USB OTG. It was like a little media hub. We managed to get a tour. That was actually pretty cool.
Unfortunately, we didn't really get any footage of it.
All of our cameras were dead.
Yeah.
All of our phones were dead.
Yep. We got some pictures.
We had one phone that wasn't dead, but it was an S3.
And we didn't want to use it.
So, our cameras and phones and everything. The battery went dead. We've used them too much. We didn't plan.
We slept in.
We didn't, actually. We got up early. We still fucked it up. Anyways. So, yeah, I apologize for the terrible video quality of this. My S3. My backup phone.
We probably should have, anyways.
Yes.
The footage would have been worth it. Would have been worth it.
How was that one picture of you in the lobby?
It was pretty bad.
Yeah.
So, yeah, we got a tour of the place. Basically, he brought us into the front, told us not to touch the paint. He was pointing at flaws in the paint, because that's just what he does. And Linus was like, I know, we're getting it fixed.
It was still wet.
It was
wet after 7 hours.
Because Vancouver is very humid.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, and they will open that all up a lot. So that the paint was still wet. It was horribly wet.
Mm.
So, he showed us his little, what do they call that? The sanity room.
The sanity room, yeah.
You might have seen it in one of the previous videos that he did, where he was talking about the Harry Potter hole.
Yeah,
they were originally going to put a toilet there. They wound up putting it somewhere else.
Behind that wall.
Yeah. He calls that a sanity room. That's where he put the server that he was 3D printing those shrouds for. Because they were waiting for that motherboard to get shipped in. Because apparently he fried the old one.
Actually, the sanity room is meant to hold project items.
Yeah.
So if they're working on a project, they put it on top. They shine it up for themselves, then they put it in that room.
So Linus doesn't have to look at it and go insane.
Yes.
Exactly. It is for his sanity.
It's for his sanity.
Yeah, and then he showed us the tech room, winds up just sitting on Luke's desk and just going, oh yeah, these are the up desks, and just like rises all the way up.
I thought he was going to hit himself in the head.
In the ceiling, yeah.
He was doing that so smooth, it's obvious he had practice. It's obvious it's like all he fucking did.
No, the up desks are actually
I can just see that now. Well. Luke is just working, and Linus goes and just hops up on his desk. And Luke's kind of like, what the fuck?
Hey, Luke! You're the right distance now.
Oh, God, he actually joked about that, too.
Oh, did he really?
Yes.
Yeah.
He also said that Lute has a timer on his computer to tell him to change his stance.
So it'll change automatically.
Yeah, because up desks, you can do sitting, standing. They're great desks.
Yes, I want one.
Yeah, yeah, that's what he was using when he was yelling orders out to his minions.
Yes.
Yes.
Like,
well, he was actually using a vert desk.
Aren't they like... There's a difference?
Yes.
I thought he was using the same desks inside.
No.
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 Okay.
The vert desk is cheaper.
Ah.
That desk is more expensive and better built.
Yeah.
Either way, though, all expensive.
Yeah, and then he showed off the rendering room. Every computer has its own UPS. And, everyone, like, they had, something crazy, like, 2 Titan Blacks or something in each computer. Crazy LG ultra-wide monitors and all that sort of stuff.
Yeah, did I send you the picture?
They weren't ultra-wide, they were 4K.
I sent you a picture of the monitors?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I have
Taryn was still Walton.
Yeah, Taryn showed us an upcoming preview.
I remember on the opposite side from him there's just a picture of just Linus angry.
Yeah.
Oh no, it's over my face. What do I do? I can't get it off. Okay, it's gone.
Mr. Muscle was pretty awesome.
Yeah. He was in the auction. Oh man. I like how he was trying, like, it's just going out of his way to be louder than Linus during the WAN show.
Yeah, he was trying to make so everyone hold him.
Yeah.
And
which
everyone by everyone.
Everyone heard him. Yeah. During the auction they actually gave away 2 Titan Black editions.
Yeah, for like
$400 each.
Yeah, $450, something like that.
Well, it started at 100, and people just kept bidding.
Yes, just the Titans.
Well, yeah, the freaking Titan Blacks. Even though one of them was water damage.
It was cosmetic water damage.
Yes.
So they claim, though.
They tested.
Yeah.
It's probably fine.
Also, Mr. Muscles was tearing everything over his head, so every fucking take he had, he... lifted over his head.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they auctioned off the computer from Scrapyard Wars.
No.
No, they gave that one away.
Yeah. Oh, they gave it away, yeah.
Yeah, right at the end, right when we were leaving.
I mean, I would have wanted that. I mean, 8 gigs, DDR2, Q6600.
I don't think it was a complete system. I think they wanted to take some of it.
Yes, that was the 290.
No, I'm pretty certain they gave that one away. Like, as a contest. The one that was there was the leftover parts from that.
I don't know. We'll have to see.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was one of the... It was the losing Scrapyard Wars computer.
I don't know.
That's what it was. It was the losing Scrapyard Wars from the first one. I think it was without the graphics card and...
No, it looked like there was a graphics card.
There was a graphics card in it?
And it looked like the 290.
Okay, yeah, then probably was the 290. Shit.
Yeah, an R9 290. I could use that.
Yeah, that'd be fucking great. The best part of that video is like when he turns it on and just recognizes the noise of the fan.
Linus
like,
is just,
what?
You've got to be kidding me. That's a reference cooler.
Yeah. It's a newer reference cooler.
Yeah.
Anyways.
Where did you get a 290 for $180?
Fuck, that would be a great deal. I have 2 290s in my case right now. $500 for my first one, and I thought that was a good deal. And I paid $300 for my second, and I thought that was a good deal. Although
Luke
they're both
got
new
one
with
for
warranties, so I suppose there's that.
And then you had to send one back 3 times.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know if I'm going to be buying from Gigabyte anymore. I mean, Gigabyte, please send me stuff. Think we're still good?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. I loved near the end of that tour, we're being shown around the warehouse, and then Linus's wife is just like, what do I do with these? And he's like, fuck it, just give them away. And she's like, okay. And then throws Linus's winning dildo at Raymond's face.
Yes!
Right in the nose!
Hit me right in the nose.
I was just like, Will, grab it!
We all just kind of stared there as it vibrated on the floor.
Vibrated away.
It was moving. We're not touching it if it moved.
It's just like, I don't want to touch it, but I kind of do. Because it was in that video. And it's the winning one.
Yeah, since it wasn't the third one. I was looking at the videos.
So, Linus's winning dildo hit Raymond in the face.
Yeah.
That's the highlight.
Yeah, your nose, like,
it
was
won your nose.
After that.
Yeah.
It won your nose.
Oh, damn it. Damn it. So yeah, that was pretty fun there.
As soon as we as the tour was over, it was just like, let's go back to the car, back to the hotel. Done for the night.
Yeah,
I was done sooner than that.
Well, they went for food first. I was not hungry. I felt like if I ate something, I was going to throw up that day.
Yeah, the heat stroke was hitting me halfway through the tour. That's why I didn't take any videos. Because I couldn't keep my hand any straighter than that. And so I was like, I can't do it.
And the phone he gave me was almost dead.
The S3?
No, you gave me your OnePlus One.
Oh, my OnePlus One. Right, yeah.
Because it was withholding. It was withholding something and you popped it.
Yeah, I noticed that. It was doing weird shit.
So basically, Saturday morning, we woke up, and 8 a.m., we drove straight back to Edmonton.
Yeah, yeah. Like, that sleep, like, the night before when I was talking about how, like, it was really hard for us to sleep in there. We got home, I was so exhausted, there was the bed, I was in it, I don't remember anything else, then I was up in the morning.
I barely just sleep that night as well, but I barely sleep right now.
Yeah, yeah. It's just this time of year?
It's just me. Yeah.
But yeah, yeah, when we woke up,
A woman actually got up that morning, too.
Yeah, yeah.
Probably because we were kind of loud when we were waking up.
Meh.
Actually, no, because she wanted breakfast as well.
That's true.
Right.
Oh, the amount of Chinese tourists there, too.
Well, the thing about Vancouver is their second language is Mandarin. Their official second language is Mandarin.
Yeah.
From Jasper.
Oh, right, yeah, yeah. From Vancouver to Kamloops, when we were going on the Coca-Cola on the way back.
It was actually nice.
Super quick.
Yeah.
Super quick. Like, it's like no time at all.
Yeah.
Even from Kamloops over to Jasper, that was actually pretty quick.
Yeah, it's hilarious. On the way to Vancouver, it was from Edmonton to Jasper, like, but on the way back, Jasper to Edmonton was like, oh my god, this takes forever.
Probably because it was the last night of the journey for both of them.
Yeah, that's probably what it was.
So our trip back was actually very eventful.
Not really.
Not really, no.
Well, yeah. When a time from Jasper to... No. Was it before Kamloops? Oh, that we almost... No, it was after.
That was Jasper. Just as we're exiting Jasper.
That was exiting Jasper, yeah. Stupid people stopped in front of us, nearly rear-ended them, nearly got rear-ended. Other than that, uneventful.
Oh, and the 20-minute show thing out of Hinton. What the hell was that? We have no idea what happened there.
All traffic stopped. There was, like, flashing lights off in the distance.
It was wet and yellow lights.
Yeah, it was too far for us to go see. And then it just started moving again. We drive past the spot where we've seen the lights. Nothing was there.
What I think...
The roads were perfectly clean. There was no debris, no oil, nothing. So
what I think happened, it was a truck with a wide load.
Yeah.
And a truck moving something from one side of the road to that.
Or maybe, like, dangerous goods that had to be escorted, or...
Well, those didn't look like...
It's probably wide load, though.
Yeah, it probably was, like, the house.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, here we are again in Jasper. We're nearing the end of our trip. Overall, I'd say it was pretty successful. We got to meet Linus, got to meet up with a lot of people. There were hundreds of people there that I did not expect. And got to see a lot of crazy stuff. I've never been outside of Alberta before, so just crossing the border was a first for me. Got to see the ocean. Yeah, it was a really fun trip. And I think it went really well. Overall, it was definitely a lot of fun. Unfortunately, once again, nothing really went wrong. Everything kind of went according to plan, so I don't really have any sort of
interesting or disaster footage to show you. It's just a good time. Uneventful, boring, good time. But that's okay. I figured I can roll with this. I can make an interesting video out of it anyways. So yeah, after all of this, after all we've done, after all we've seen, I guess it's about time for me to do this. As this boat passes us by, I have to admit it. This is the end of our adventure. If you liked this video, give it a like. If you disliked it, give it a dislike. If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe. And with that, may the Mecca be with you.